So in this particular video, you guys, me and my wife decided we wanted to go to this special place we always wanted to go to. We wanted to go for our anniversary, but we didn't have no one to watch our babies. I know we are full-time parents, and we decided to go today. My brother had an off day today, so we decided to go spend time with each other, show each other some love and respect, and say our vows to each other, and just release any type of stress. And one thing about marriage, when you're a full-time mother, parents, period, you don't know how to, you know, be just wives or husband and wife. You're all the time a parent. So we just wanted to go refresh our mind, show some respect and love to each other. And yeah, and we wanted to share this with you guys as well. So marriage is one thing that you don't take for granted, and love is something that is so beautiful, and we love each other dearly, and I love this woman to death, and I wouldn't change any of this for the world. So yeah, just watching you guys, and don't forget to like, subscribe, and comment, and turn on your post notification, and just talk to us, comment down below, let us know how you like this video. Yeah, we love y'all.
Cabana thing. know me, I love the sound of water. I don't know why. Y'all, she had this screen protector on her phone, which, like, if somebody was next to her, they can't read her messages because, you know, when you're grown, she in the military, like, you know, you might want to send your dad a picture or a video. Yeah, can't nobody else see. So, when she take pictures outside, she can't see nothing, even inside. I don't know. These things fly too close. No, not those. It was something else. So, how was this? Wonderful. Yeah, it was just a way, honestly. Yeah, definitely. Like, I wanted to cry so bad. And no, me too.
It's just like, it's not even the fact that it's a crying moment, but it's just like,
yeah. I'm not about to play with these shits. Hell no. Huh? Yeah, went right past my hand. Good thing it didn't sting.
It definitely was. I just, like, I keep telling her, like, I feel like something so big, like, so big good-wise, like, is about to happen to us. Like, you ever just wake up and you just feel it? I really felt it on the day of Raya's party. Remember when I told you about it? So, story was, right, everybody was outside. And I was the one running back and forth getting stuff because the neighbors basically had, like, the tables and chairs and stuff because the place we got the bounce house from, it was part of the package, but they weren't sending them out due to coronavirus, which I understood because I wouldn't do it either.
Yeah.
So I was going back and forth, and there was one time I went inside, and like, I don't know if it was just like God like stopping me in my tracks and just made me like just really just think like wow, like I'm really, really like grateful and thankful for like where I am. Cause there's so many different paths that you can be on, and like I really feel like truly this is the right path that I'm on. But it wasn't even that. It's just like it stopped me, and then I just started feeling it like something really big is about to happen. And you really can't put your finger on what's the big thing.
Exactly. And you know, it's like we know something big is gonna happen and we ready for it. You know what I mean? Like, it's not no rush to it.
Yeah.
It's just like when it comes, we're gonna be grateful. Because we've been through a lot. Like we said, family wise, me mental wise,
health,
yeah. It's just been so much. And it's that one day that you get that you be like, I just want to change. I wanted everything to be different. Like, you want better for yourself and for, you know, people that you love.
Yeah.
And things like that. I'm definitely ready for it. I always, you know, when you're young, you always say like, oh, I'm going to have a big house. I'm going to have this. I want this many kids or a big backyard and stuff like that.
Mm.
And you don't know, you can't feel that yet, but you're saying what you want to have. But it's like right now where we are today, I feel like that will happen. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
Like everything that we dreamed of, what we put together in our heads, said to each other, it's going to happen one day. And there's no rush to it, but definitely feel like something good is gonna happen.
Yeah.
I've been seeing like angel numbers, literally.
There's just been too many signs for anything to be bad right now.
Exactly.
Even if we have like these little small disagreements within ourselves, like, telling y'all, in the past, we could never find a way to come together and just be able to just sit down and just talk. It always ended up like an argument. But like recently, we had something happen and we was texting about it. In my head, I was like, nah, we can't text about this. And I ended up calling her while I was at work.
I was half asleep, y'all.
And I was like, nah, we gonna talk about this.
I was like, what? It just shocked me, like, because usually, like she said, we argue before we just be like, okay, now let's sit down and talk about this. This time it was more of, let me talk about this before we get into an argument. And that's growth. And it was just, I just told her, like, you shocked me, like, that was so amazing. Crazy. And now it's just like, that's why we wanted to say our vows to each other. And get over the past. Like, everything that happened in the past is like, we gotta keep growing from that. Like, I've always said that I wanted to let a lot of things go, not just within our relationship from the past, but like my childhood, everything. I just wanted to let it go. And right now, you can't go to church and get baptized because this whole virus. So, it's just a fresh start for us.